Welcome to r/entitledparents, where a racist entitled Karen tries to steal my dog but fails miserably. I'm from India and I moved to America to finish my studies. I'm 20 years old now. I adopted a cute German Shepherd puppy 2 years ago. I named him Negan. I'm a huge Walking Dead fan. And I somehow trained him to growl whenever the classic Negan whistle played. You'll know what I'm talking about if you've seen The Office in the US. Jim does this to Dwight. It took me a really long time to do this, but it finally worked. And it was really helpful. So there I am, just casually walking Negan. And a lady and her son come up to me and ask if she and her son can pet Negan. I shrug and say whatever. They start petting him. Her hand slowly went towards Negan's collar. I didn't care much because I knew Negan would never walk away from me. I noticed that she had removed the leash from the collar, and Negan was just standing there. She started to do the thing you do when you call your cat. Yeah, that one. Negan just stood there. The kid said, "Mom, you said when the dog runs away we should take it." I was dying inside. I suddenly thought this was the right moment to use the new training. By the way the lady was trying to shut her kid up, she looked up at me and smiled. I just looked at her with a pissed face. She tries to call Negan again. He doesn't go. He doesn't like to go near strangers unless they have food. I just made up a complete story. It went something like this. Lady, you're a trying to steal my dog.
How dare—
Shut up. Listen, if you wanted, you could have just had the dog.
What?
Yep, I need to get rid of this dog. He is a killing machine. He will rip anyone or anything apart who he doesn't like. For instance, I whistled. Negan began to growl. The lady started to freak out. She backed away a little. I suggest you run. He will mess you up so bad, they won't be able to recognize your body. The kid, oh my god, he was so scared. He said,
"Mommy, I don't want this doggy. He bad."
I was dying inside. That's when the racist rant began. By now, Negan stopped growling. The lady slowly started to back the f*** up.
"You stupid Mexicans don't deserve to have dogs as pets. You guys kill dogs."
"Fuck off before I let him rip you into shreds."
"That dog should be put down. He doesn't deserve to live. He's dangerous."
I whistle again. She starts hauling her ass out of there. I burst out laughing. She even f***ing tripped. And at the end, guess who got extra treats? Also, for those of you who wanted to know how I trained Negan to do that, basically, I showed him something he hates every time I whistled. For instance, pickles. He hates them. And now, every time I whistle, he thinks I'm gonna try to feed him a pickle. Haha, this is priceless. OP really made her trip in fear of a dog who just didn't want to eat some pickles. Haha. A perfect example of when preparation meets opportunity. She deserved it. Way to go. This next story features another crazy Karen who freaked out and keyed this guy's car for being too loud. So for some background. The car wasn't mine. It was my brother-in-law's. He is suing her for about 60 grand for the damages. I don't know the exact car model, but it's a muscle car and it's manual. Characters: me, brother-in-law, sis, Karen, mom, P1, P2. So it all started when I decided I wanted to start learning stick. Since my brother-in-law is the only person I know with a manual car, I had him come over and teach me. When the car starts up, it does make a rather loud rev. We made sure to do it in the afternoon as not to wake people up and try to be considerate. Anyways, it was about the third or fourth day of him teaching me when she first appeared. Karen:
nice car. Bit too loud for my taste, but still, it's nice.
Me: oh, thanks.
Mind trying time to keep it down a bit? My baby doesn't really seem to like it that much.
Yeah, sure. We've been driving it in the day so it doesn't wake people up. I didn't know anyone around here had a baby, so I'm sorry about that.
It's not a problem. Just be quiet, okay?
With that condescending tone and smile on her face, she walked off. Which kind of made me mad, because I just thought it was a friendly chat. It wouldn't be the first time people have talked to me about brother-in-law's car, thinking it's mine. I have grown to accept that people will think whatever, so I play along and just tell brother-in-law about it later. 2 days go by with no sign of her. I wake up, get ready, and wait for brother-in-law to come over so we can start my lesson. I walk outside, and lo and behold, she was there.
I thought I told you to keep it down.
Sorry, I can't control it. It's just how the car starts, and we're not going to leave it running while we're not in it. That's just a waste of gas.
I don't care. Stop being so loud.
With that, she was gone.
It always annoys me when people complain about cars being loud. A car is a motor vehicle with a combustion engine in it. Of course it's going to make noise. Brother-in-law got to my place, and off we went. We came back to my house to eat lunch. About 2 or so hours later, my sister and mom come over and tell brother-in-law and I to go look at the car. The entire driver's side was scratched up, and even a tire was popped. Only one person came to mind when I saw it. Karen. We, meaning me and brother-in-law, walked down to her house, which was only a few houses down, and knocked on her door. All we hear coming from the other side is, "I'm not apologizing." So this led brother-in-law to say, "Then you better have a good case in court, you That's more gonna cost a lot to fix, and I'm suing you for every cent."
"Maybe keep it down then, you hick."
"Maybe don't go keying cars and popping tires and you won't get sued, you bimbo." This went on for about 20 minutes. We head back, call the police, and get everything ready for what was about to come. As soon as they got there, we started to explain what happened, how I was learning stick, how the car was, showed them the damages, told them what the Karen said, etc. We were making sure our side was accurate, so we made sure our timeline was correct. After a while, we walked with the police to her house, and it went down about as well as you'd expect. Police officer 1. "Excuse me, ma'am. Can you come out here for a minute? This is the blank PD, wanting to speak to you about a car."
"I'm not apologizing. I told them to keep it down and they didn't. They deserve it."
Police officer 2. "Ma'am, what you did is against the law and they are pressing charges. You have 5 minutes to get out here or we will get a warrant for your arrest and come back."
"Nice try, but I'm not stupid. I know my rights and you're not allowed to enter my home without my consent or a search warrant."
"That's only partially true. We can't search your home without a warrant. However, if we have a warrant for your arrest, we can legally enter your home and place you into custody."
She was stubborn. Again, they went back and forth for a bit. After the allotted time set, we went back to my house. The cops left to go get a warrant, and we waited. Currently, the lawsuit is in order, and the trial is in a few days. She is in police custody. I have never found it easier to drive a stick shift knowing I won't have to deal with her condescending ways and tones. While I can understand this Karen's anger, and maybe OP should have been more courteous of a request, her reaction was too extreme considering the baby wasn't in any actual harm. Babies cry at all types of sounds, and it's just what comes with raising a kid. In this final story, a vicious 40-year-old Karen stalked my 11-year-old son for not liking her daughter. Basically, there was a little girl in my son's class, 5th graders, 11 years old, who would say my son was bullying her. At first, we believed the teachers, her, and would discipline him at home, but his story was always consistent that he wasn't doing it, and then he started gathering witnesses who confirmed that he was not bullying her, and there were never people corroborating her stories. The stories also just frankly didn't sound like him or anything he'd do. Kids also said she was bullying him and other kids by pushing them. We also learned that she had put a love note in his backpack and he didn't notice it and left it crumbled there for months without being addressed. It was right around the time she sent it that the accusations of bullying started. You would think that this story would end with just a few calls to the principal and parents, but it did not. The girl's mom started showing up at school to stalk, stare at my son during breakfast, lunch, and at dismissal. She also tried to get him kicked out of a sport. Coach said he has never seen bullying, and if so, he will deal with it. And the mom sent letters to other kids' parents saying that my kid was a bully and they shouldn't let their kids play with him. And she would spread this same thing by word of mouth. I felt completely overwhelmed because I work and did not have the ability or relationships with other families to correct this craziness. I also tried talking to the Karen mom directly, but she denied that her daughter could possibly make the bullying up, saying, "That is not how I raised her." She also denied stalking my son.
"That would be crazy."
And read the letter that was sent to the other parents to me and acted like it was totally normal for her to do that. Then, one day she brought along her much older son to breakfast who physically attacked my kid. When the principal told her that this situation had gotten out of hand and she couldn't bring her older son to school to intimidate students, she declared that she was going to start homeschooling her child. This was the Friday before school let out for spring break, and by the following week, we were at distance learning. So in a way, that was actually the case for everyone for the rest of the school year. My son is starting a new school tomorrow, middle school, and he keeps asking if any other moms will do that again and if I will ever go to school for lunch to make sure no moms stalk him. I keep thinking about this situation like, what the f***? I am so sorry this situation happened to you and your son, OP. It's crazy when some people think it's acceptable regardless of if the bullying was actually happening. What is that teaching the children? Jeez.